starting the show from behind you.
That's right.
Because you're so small, I can't surprise you. Okay? There's a big audience, there's tons of people. Like in Montreal, there's like, you know, 60 people. So I could surprise people by starting at the back. But I'm going to have to start at the front because you're not a good audience. And this is audience participatory. So you got to play along with me. Are you ready? I'm ready. There are walls to the left. There are walls to the left. You gotta participate. This is Vancouver. Everybody participates in Vancouver. It's a participatory city. It's well known around the world. People participate. When I do a line, you do a line and clap. Got it?
Okay.
Count of 14. 1, 2, 14. There are walls to the left.
There are walls to the left.
There are walls to the right.
There are walls to the right.
There are walls that surround us.
There are walls that surround us.
Turn day into night.
Turn day into night.
Walls that divide us.
Walls that divide us.
And keep us apart.
And keep us apart.
Walls that imprison us.
Walls that imprison us.
Alone in the dark.
Alone in the dark.
Walls of deceit.
Walls of deceit.
Walls of hypocrisy.
Walls of hypocrisy.
Walls of ignorance.
Walls of ignorance.
Walls of. Walls of.
Walls of.
We already did that.
Oh, okay.
We did hypocrisy, did deceit, did ignorance.
Walls of lies?
Walls of lies. Walls of lies. Walls that keep us.
Walls that
keep us.
All alone in the dark.
All alone in the dark.
It's time, my friends.
It's time, my friends.
Step out of the shadows.
Step out of the shadows.
It's time, my friends.
It's time, my friends.
To step out of the shadows.
Step out of the shadows.
We gotta tear down those walls.
Gotta tear down those walls.
Brick by brick.
Brick by brick.
Stone by stone.
Stone by stone.
And we're gonna dance on the brick.
Gonna dance on the
bricks. We're gonna dance on the stones.
We're gonna party.
Sing and shout.
We're gonna build ourselves a road.
To freedom.
Harper's
Wall.
Not
even Harper's Wall. Keep us out.
Keep us.
They'll not keep us out.
Keep us.
They'll not keep us out.
Not keep us.
You could think that's it. Yes. Welcome to my book launch. I'm so happy to be back in Vancouver. I was born, grew up, raised. What else did I do? Got drunk for the first time ever in Vancouver. And I'm very, very happy to be back with my 13th book, but it's actually my 15th if I include the Italian-French translations. And today's October the 15th. So 15th book and the 15th of October. 2015. I think that's pretty cool. But anyway, okay. So, and the book was wonderfully illustrated by a dear friend, illustrator in Montreal called Mathieu Chartrand, who took my poems and actually did a dozen illustrations with them. And I'm very happy with this book because it's a sum of my last year of writing work, with a couple of older pieces thrown in, and it kind of reflects my mood this past year, given what's going on in the world all around us, not just in Montreal where I live right now, and not just in Quebec, where I live, and not just in this country, but the entire world. So it reflects a whole lot of emotions and a lot of gut reaction, because this is how I work as a socially engaged artist. I react to things, and I want to talk about things. And I also sometimes want to pick up my violin and do things with my violin. So the very first piece in the book is called A Bluebird Sang, and I want to do this for you.
inside the walls of a prison. Oh, prisoners, listen. It was a beautiful song. A song of freedom. Prisoner, shout it to the bird. You can't sing outside my prison. Stop, or I'll kill you. The bird kept singing. The prison bird killed it. And all the prisoners cried. Outside the walls of the prison, thousands of birds gathered.
Called? Is there still a village?
Davie.
On Davie, right? Okay, so you know the village on Davie, right? And you know people hang out there all day and night and do whatever they gotta do. Well, the same thing in Montreal. Our village is kind of big and kind of, it's quite vibrant, and things happen there sometimes, the things you would never expect. And this is a piece that was inspired by a story a friend told me about what happened to somebody in the village.
Dick challenged punch.
is to be. Never forget. Tolerance is not acceptance, it's hypocrisy. Tolerance is never acceptance, it's hypocrisy. Bash of homophobes until they come home. Bash those homophobes until they come home. Bash until they come home. So I get my news on the internet, and like you, the images from around the world come into my study, my workspace on my screen, and like you, probably they affect me as well, and more so than ever before, I think, because of the amount of photography that's being practiced out there. And I think it's a good thing that, you know, what is being documented today, especially by visual artists. A lot of stuff we didn't have access to before. And so what's happening in the Middle East, and as a consequence of what's happening in the Middle East around the world, we're learning more and more every day, hearing all the news, and sometimes it's overwhelming, sometimes it's hard to make sense of, and I try to make sense of it. And this was based on one of those news photos which came out online, and I just responded. So it's called Under the Wire.
Curly hair. You, a refugee from war, famine,
think you can cross inhuman borders at will and escape? This blade, the made in Germany weapon system that targeted your neighborhood. This blade, the made in Canada helicopter gunship engine that brought invaders to your village. This blade, the made in America missile that destroyed your home. This blade, the made in Britain concertina razor wire that blocks your dreams of peace, freedom, and terror three nights of sleep. There is no escape in wars. Wars are destroyed by those safe and far from your suffering. No escape from the global chaos induced by horrific rivalries and the crisis of imperialism. No escape through inhospitable countries that snag, scratch, claw your beating heart and call you. Yes, you. You. Yes, you. 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 Yes, you. 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 A terrorist. No escape for you. A 4-year-old refugee girl with big brown eyes. City in Saskatchewan. And what's the next biggest city called?
In Saskatchewan? No, what's the biggest city in Saskatchewan?
Saskatchewan.
Regina.
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 Right? It's bigger, isn't it?
I live in Saskatchewan, so
I'm not sure.
Come on. More
popular. They're equal.
Equal? I don't think so.
Yes, Saskatchewan is pretty small.
Hey. I've been to Saskatoon quite a bit for shows, touring. I have lots of friends in Saskatoon. And I've been up in northern Saskatchewan as well, Prince Albert and places like that. And I hate to say it, but you got a problem there in Saskatchewan.
Yes.
It's not just the pollution coming from the oil, the tar sands, and it's not just the ordinary everyday evils of capitalism. It's something else going on. It starts with a big R, it's a capital R, and it has to do with police force in Saskatchewan, and particularly in the city of Saskatoon. And I know Montreal's got the worst police force in the country. You claim Vancouver's is really bad, but you're a bunch of wusses compared to what cops in Montreal do, but they're actually wusses compared to what the cops in Saskatoon do, if you happen to be a certain kind of person, and it's something we have to talk about. A lot of people don't really know about it, but there's been a couple of books written about it. It's been in the news at some points, and I felt like I had to write something about it. So this is called Another Starlight Tour, and if you're from Saskatoon, you know what that's all about.
But none of you have been to Saskatoon. Or
I
just
lived there.
Oh,
yeah, you
lived
there. I booked you for a show there.
That's true. You did book me for a show.
Jesus.
There. Yes, it's true. She did live there. My dear friend Christine lived in Saskatoon and booked me for a show there.
How drunk were we?
We weren't that drunk.
Thank you.
drunken Indians to mess with all night. Find them, grab them, load them in the car, and take them for a tour under all those stars. Oh yeah, under all those stars. Drive past the city limits where the moon shines so bright, then dump them on the highway and tell them to walk back tonight. It's minus 30 if they freeze. Too bad. They're only drunken Indians. So who gives a damn? Who gives a damn? Wearing only a t-shirt, jacket, jeans, and left with only one shoe. They're only drunken Indians, so who gives a damn? The bodies pile up along the highway. We're in a field, frozen solid, far outside the city of Saskatoon. They ruled one was a victim of misadventure, froze to death at his own volition, another 8 months pregnant. The officers didn't care. Why should they? Except for the stars and moon above. No one's ever counted how many went missing all these years. There are only drunken Indians. So who would give a damn? I'm compelled to write about things like this, and I'm compelled to share these stories, and I'm compelled to put them in my books and then share them like live with people, because a lot of people just don't have a clue. And I'm privileged. I get to travel a lot, and I'm privileged, I guess, because I can take the time to listen, to watch, to talk with people, to share what they're going through, to write down the stories and try and do something with them as an artist with a social conscience. And I think it's up to all artists. I know you guys are all artists with social consciences, but there's other artists who sometimes come to my presentations who haven't necessarily thought about that and are always wondering, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna work about? What's my subject? What's so easy? It's out there, it's in the streets, it's all around us. And that's what should be, you know, part of your artwork. That's what should inspire you. That's what should move you. And if more of us talked about these issues, if more of us brought them to public attention, into public discourse, then maybe we can actually start doing something about them. Because this is the kind of injustice that has to stop. One of many, obviously, but it's kind of easy to address and it should be stopped. Anyway, let's move to something completely different on a world scale. I can't stand listening to Stephen Harper anymore. I can't stand looking at his face. I can't stand another news report. I cannot. I'm sick to my stomach. And I especially hate his fear-mongering. I know my father was, you know, driven to crazy things as a result of like taking in all this fear-mongering during the whole 9/11 crisis. You know, other people were terrified into doing things they would have thought of during that 9/11, post-9/11, and we're still living in this post-9, you know, fear-mongering mentality world, and it has to stop, it really has to stop. So this is what I'm going to do, and I wrote a piece about it called Terrorism. Thank you. Montreal closet, the one you stuff full of junk? Handy. Close the door. No questions. No one knows. Secret. Hide everything. Only at night do you hear the protest shouts, shrieks. Doors are thin. When there's a tear in the cerebral fabric, a falling tear from a woman newly widowed by a drone strike, not collateral damage, a bullseye to stop the terrier howling in grief. Its master killed by terror in the eyes of the teddy bear hugging girl. When a soldier kicks in her house door, no go, no fly, no work, blacklist for you, held incommunicado, no need to justify, just throw away all keys, a politically expedient, racially profiled, terror washed away, all-purpose intelligence remover, every suspect humbled into perfectly square, torture chamber, rendered into the blackness in the late 19th, early 20th centuries. Anarchists! The boogeyman womanisms of choice. Emma Goldman was up. All foreigners, they said, bearded, caricatured, strike fear into the frightening unthinking. Radical wobblies, anti-American, tarred, feathered, I'm communist! Scarier than the Twilight Zone. Peaceniks, hippies, student radicals, war resistors, anti-globalization activists, more anarchists. Who can least defend themselves? Now it's anti-pipeline environmentalists, First Nations people, other anarchists, investigative journalists, 10-year-old Palestinian girls. Blame them for bad coffee, traffic jams, reptile dysfunction, unemployment. 21st century terrorist scum. Lock them all up. Like Japanese noodles or soup in a mug. Add hot water, eat it up. Convenience, simplicity justifies bus stop, washroom, park bench, surveillance cameras, microphones, built-in chips to monitor your every fingerboard key caress. Militarize, police, control, neutralize. Rational debate about the necessity, impossible, the terrorist unbeliever, frighten them enough, they'll accept anything you say, push the terror tinted glasses, color blind, this white person, killing, bombing, white power, terrorists don't exist, right wing ones, neither, homegrown, hard to happen, we don't terrorize, they do. But isn't war just legalized? Push the terror tinted glasses. Sensationalized today. Oops, sorry. Wrong accusation. Maybe tomorrow. Forget the real perpetrators of global chaos. Go, team, go! Worldwide tyranny supporters. We're number one. Instruments of death suppliers. Yay! Warmongering, plundering refugee creators. Those here responsible for deep stabilization over there. Really? Of course, people will get angry with me. He threw his shoe at the lying president. The child bit the arm of the occupying soldier. The last words of mother buried under the rubble. Terrorize the horizon. Recycle violence, not peace or humanitarianism. It's raining terrorists. Bomb them into the age of dust to watch how they crawl away from the oil fields. Expendable otherworlders, keeping Western shareholders healthy, happy, wealthy. Groan them into hell holes, family after family, or flush them into the blood-red churning oceans of your endless nightmares. By morning, dead children wash up on the beach, golden, golden. Close to your ear. Listen to their laughter. Unveil the real terrorists. They wear happy faces, are powdered heavily before they open their mouths on TV to scare. Boom! Nice try, dumb guy. It's a fetish. They can't terrorize enough. The darker the skin, the bigger the beard, the better the villainous, the easier the lie like bedbugs, roaches, or no-see-ums. Objectify, dehumanize, point the big finger, kill, arrest, kill, imprison, kill, torture, kill, silence! Guantanamo! Each country builds its own, brainwashes each citizen to do the same. The insecurity industry rivals the porn industry, a sure investment. It's a symphonic movement, orchestrated well to serve anti-terror and Uncle Bill. Stone two pigeons with another new law, freedom to dissent. We're not taking any more questions. There's no more opposition anyway. It's the everyday, systemic, greed-driven, legalized, fear-mongering, freedom-robbing, official terrorism that really hurts. Do not be afraid. Fight. go. You know what time it is now. It's your turn. Are you ready, ladies and gentlemen, and everyone in between? Okay. Yeah. I was in this really cool bar performing the book launch the other night, two nights ago. I just came into Vancouver last night. Yeah, flew in last night. And I'm just slightly jet-lagged, but the night before I was in Montreal, and this other really cool bar, equally cool as Spartacus, even though Spartacus is not a bar, but imagine Spartacus being an equally cool bar. Imagine somebody being, a woman being physically assaulted in Spartacus. This happened in a super cool bar in Montreal. Like the last place you expect a woman to be physically assaulted. And this guy was bugging her. She was on the dance floor. The DJ was playing. She was on the dance floor, and they're up dancing, having a good time. This guy kept coming on to her, and she's like, "No, I'm not interested with my friends. Leave me alone. Leave me alone." He wouldn't listen. And he started to get physical with her, and she pushed him. So he tried to strangle her.
Oh,
yeah. So she grabbed her beer glass, whack, on his head.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Cut. Blood. And the guy fell on the ground. Like, "Ah, I'm bleeding out." He fell on the ground. The ambulance came. They took him away. The cops were going to charge her with assault. And it's like, fuck you, fuck you. They wouldn't listen to her. To top it off, and this is the worst part, I think.
She went on Facebook the next day
and wrote about her experience and posted a photo of herself after she had stitches, because he actually hit her and she had stitches. I think he broke her nose or something, yeah.
Mm.
Even though she hit him with the glass, they think he broke her nose at the same time, whatever, it was a struggle. She went on Facebook, posted the story, and received thousands of woman-hating, you know, anti-feminist, despicable, reproachable comments from guys saying, you know, he should have killed you, you know, he should have done this to you, you know, you deserved everything you got, and you're good for nothing, blah, 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 blah. And I was just like, fuck that shit, what the fuck is going on? I do anti-sexist, queer-positive, sex-positive sex shows to try and stop that. Steve, my dear friend, brought me to Quantum College, how many years ago? 10, 15?
11 years ago.
11 years ago, okay? You know, to do an anti-sexist sex show at this college. And the idea, I do these shows across the country. Once upon a time, I thought I would stop doing the shows because guys would evolve. You know, we would evolve, right? Eventually. And we would see the light. We would not do stupid things like this guy did to this woman there. So anyway, so I wrote a piece. And I wrote a piece also inspired by what a friend was telling me she was going through in Italy as a performer, being harassed every night. Originally, it was for her. And I thought, no, I'm dedicating this woman there who fights back. So this is dedicated to all the women who fight back. And it shouldn't be up to women to fight back. It should be for guys to stop doing what they're doing so women don't have to fight back. That's the real message. But you get to participate. Normally I'd have a disco beat, but my sister's drum machine didn't have a disco beat. So we got this like potpourri of beats from all around the world. And you're gonna sing with me. Are you ready?
If I have to make that noise.
No, you have to make something a little more intelligent than that. You guys gotta go. But it's not true, not true. Can you say that?
It's not true.
Even you, yeah. All the women, all the men, everybody in between. So that's one line. Another line is not true, not true. Another line, not cool, not cool. Can you do that?
Not cool.
Another line. That's true. That's true. Not true. Not true. That's true. Okay. So you got that? You got the lines? Okay, those are your lines, okay? Now, normally I would have had, and I said this in Montreal, it almost happened, the Black Eyed Peas with me, okay? Because they're dear friends and they'd be up here backing me up, but they couldn't make it, they're busy, right? So I got my sister's drum machine. So the sister's drum machine is going on, and I'm gonna point to you and you're gonna hear your line, and you gotta say your line, right? Okay, and think disco, even though it's not disco, think disco. So move your hips when you say the lines. Are you ready? Okay, get your disco, get disco glow things on, go. Okay, here it goes.
It's the potpourri.
Hey dude, you think you're really cool, walking down the street like you're the shit and you totally rule, but it's not true, not true, not true, not true, not true, not true. You think every woman you see is gonna wanna, need to have to fuck you, whether she knows it or not. Not true, not true, not true, not true. You talk out loud with your dick before you even think. You make stupid moves, say stupid things. It's not cool, not cool, not cool, not cool, not cool, not cool. Hey, like, hey, babe, wanna suck my cock? Or hey, babe, show me your tits. make you sound like a fucking fool. Not smart, not smart, not smart, not smart, not smart, not smart. You think she's gonna flip, go crazy over you. You say stupid stuff and think you're being cool. Try lame, really lame. That's true, it's true. That's true, it's true. That's true, it's true. Why play Mr. Macho Cool? You want to impress other dudes. Say woman want a guy that sounds like every other fool. Think again. Not true, not true, not true. Come on, guys. Not true, not true. You don't respect anyone, it's the dumbest thing to do. Cause you don't respect others, why should anyone respect you? That's true, it's true. That's true, it's true. That's true, it's true. Every woman has to hear stupid comments every day from guys who don't get it, no matter what they say. Not cool, not cool, not cool, not cool. Look, don't leer, smile, don't stare. Say nothing, respect your space. Know your place. Keep it cool. That's cool. Keep it cool. That's cool. Keep it cool. That's cool. Cut the stupid shit. Don't make any kind of move. Cause you think it's what expected of you. Slow down. Read. Think. It's better. It's true. It's better. It's true. It's better. It's true. Say smart. Think twice. Respect woman. Be nice. Show charm. Be a genuine human. Not a stupid clown. Keep it cool. That's cool. Keep it cool. That's cool. Keep it cool. That's cool. Stand up for a woman. They'll appreciate you. Tell other dudes to smarten up too. Be brave. Be smart. Be charming. Be respectful with everyone. And that's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool.
I don't think that's winning any Grammys.
I live, as some of you know, near the edge of downtown Montreal. And I was hanging out in this bar one night with one of my friends, and it was kind of cold outside. And it's a neighborhood where I live, where a lot of First Nations people who are homeless hang out and, you know, ask for spare change and, you know, socialize, because there's no public space. There's very little public space for people who are street people who hang out in Montreal anymore. They build condos, they, you know, put up fences. It's the same thing happened in Vancouver, right? It's like anti-homeless everywhere you go. Same thing in Montreal. So there we are, sitting inside this bar, and there's a guy who I think I'd seen before on the street. It's dark out, can barely make him out, but I see him, and I see somebody else come into the picture. And this piece is called This Little Old Woman. By the way, I want to thank Alan so very, very much for bringing me his trusty amp and his trusty mic to use tonight. Thank you, makes a big difference. Upstairs and returned
clutching an overcoat in her hands. Again, she headed for the grill. This time, the homeless man sat up. They exchanged a few words. She handed him the coat, and ever so slowly, shuffled away. This little old woman, despite the cold, despite her own problems, a spark of humanity, burning bright, lit up the entire dark sky. It was awesome. It was inspiring. I was so proud to be somebody living in Montreal, like during that historic moment, the biggest social movement we've ever seen, I've ever experienced. I wrote a collection of poetry called Red Student Strike Poetry about it, and I'm currently working on a short novel, a novella, about the strike as well. The city was completely rebranded, redecorated in red. Everywhere you look, there was red. Red on lampposts, red on trees, red on parking meters, red on bicycles, people all dressed in red. It just went on and on and on. It was a beautiful, beautiful sight. And when the kids marched in the street, we're talking kids, 17, 18, 19, and even younger high school kids, marching face to face with confrontations with cops who were like twice their size, three times their size, brutalizing them in the streets, and the kids didn't back down. They just linked arms, stood there, took the punches, took the blows of the riot sticks, and just stood there. And finally, thanks to them, the provincial Liberal government was actually toppled. New government came in with promises not to increase tuition. Well, that's all bullshit. You know, tuition went up. Now today we're fighting the Liberal government back in power with their new austerity program, which means cutbacks everywhere you look. In the entire public service sector, schools, hospitals, daycares, you name it, community services. And just this past weekend, we had a huge 200,000 person protest in the streets of public service workers and supporters. 200,000 people saying, you know, it was a common front of all the trade unions and public service workers. On November 2nd and 3rd, a few hundred community spaces are shutting down on strike for 2 days to demonstrate that the severity of the problem. They can no longer provide services for people most in need because of this stupid austerity program. So the big fight is starting all over again. This one's called Red Waves Massing. Thank you. The red birds flying so high. Were the red flowers growing between the cracks? Or the red bricks building and building? Were the red notes played by a symphony in tune? With all the black keys? Were the red corn swaying in the wind? Rooted to the red earth underfoot? As the fading red sun steps on the rising on fire? With a spoon of red fish swimming free all night long under a bulbous red moon? With the red wine flowing from the bottle to your lips? To nudge your dreams beyond the stars, with the burning red hunger of all our souls, the never red enough song of all our desires, illuminating the red, red sky that dawns. Supporting the work that I do, and all the best. I'll see you another time.